All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Vici Gaming versus Lie Gaming. It's our second best of three for the playoffs here in Star Ladder China Season 10. And it's game one of the best of three right now. So with that said, we did hop into the draft a little bit later than planned. The reason is that Perfect World is giving us a hard time, and it seems, unfortunately, the server booted Winter during the load, and it didn't even show him a reconnect button. He could not get back in the game, so I'm going to see if the admin was willing to remake it so we can have his commentary in client. Otherwise, I will solo cast so that those of you who paid good money for the ticket aren't missing out on anything, and we'll hopefully get Winter in here for game number two as he is going to stand by. Sorry about the delays in getting into the game. I was just trying to see if he could reconnect. Tried some console commands, nothing worked, so... Well, there you go. And with that said, draft's underway. We're pretty far along, but the quick recap is, bans, all very standard. Death Prophet was allowed through. Vici Gaming got a Scarath Mage Centaur as a reply for the Death Prophet. Lie Gaming pick up Rubick. Really nice support against the Centaur. Obviously, stealing Stampede is amazing. Rubick's good at counter-initiating. When Centaur jumps in, you just lift him, toss him back, and Vici Gaming will go back for a Lich here. They did this actually before seeing the Morphling pick come out. So I'm thinking from Lie Gaming, they see this Lich pick. They know Vici Gaming love to run the Morphling-Lich dual lane. And they decide, we can't let them have that. So they pick up the Morphling for themselves. And then end things now with a Doom as we complete the second stage of picks. It's a bit of a greedy opening from Lie Gaming. But that said, this team did run a very effective four-position jungling Doom recently, I believe. That was HGT. But yeah, there has been some effective four-position Doom play. So it's possible we see that. Otherwise, farming Doom, Morphling, and Death Prophet, you really need a second support who gets stuff done in the laning stage. Create some space for this team. Vici Gaming go back for the Elder Titan now. So they get I don't know if I'd call it a full counter to the Morphling, but definitely the best hero to match up against him outside of Doom. Yeah, removing all his armor, obviously very annoying for Morphling. He's entirely agility-based for getting his armor. So he's very squishy against Elder Titan. And now, to top things off, Vici Gaming do something different. They're going to pick up a Riki here. And sounds like we might have a remake, but no promises until it actually happens. Yeah, so Riki picked up. Ooh, Riki was run yesterday by Hellraisers. They destroyed Na'Vi with it in the Star Ladder Europe group stage play. And I'm excited to see it again. Obviously, the main things here is that the silence is amazing against Morphling. That's really the main thing. Riki is also decent against Death Prophet, but she generally builds a Yule Scepter, and if you ever get clouded by Riki, you just Yules yourself in the air, and you can dodge most of the additional damage that happens then. Our players will finish selecting their heroes, so Lie Gaming pick up this Lashrak. And we are going to have that quick remake, so hopefully Winter can get in. So thank you to all the players for their patience. And we're going to hop into the new game. So, Riki, exciting stuff. And I'm just trying to make sure Winter can get in the game now. And looks like he is, in fact, in. All right, Winter. Hello, my friend. How are you? You with me, Winter?
Hello. Sorry, I think I was muted.
Okay, so did you get to watch the draft at all?
I only watched, like, the last two heroes. They haven't finished loading. Then I had to leave to join the lobby.
So it's going to be Riki. Riki for Vici.
What was the other four heroes? I think I saw Centaur.
So they went Centaur, Skyrath Mage, I think it was their first two. I think that's right. Yeah, Centaur, Skyrath Mage, and then they picked up Lich, because they had the first pick in the second stage. And I think Lie Gaming saw that, and they're like, all right, we're not giving Vici Gaming that stupid Morphling Lich duo, which they use so much with TI4. So instead of allowing them to get that, they picked the Morphling for themselves. Then they picked a Doom, so they now have a Morphling Doom Death Prophet Tricore, and the Rubik Lishrak supports for Lie Gaming.
Okay, so they're going to do the CM mode all over again.
Yeah, I think they'll just run through the bans quickly. I don't think it's a redraft, just so that the actual game has like a record of the bans and the picks. So hopefully the teams do remember. But yeah, so it was like a block pick by Lie Gaming, I think, going for that Morphling. They're picking Night Heroes in a different order now. This was the Lich was third pick before, but whatever. I guess it doesn't really matter. Yeah, Lich so strong, first pick material now.
So must be, I think it's a dual lane with the Lich and Ricky middle lane. Because this used to be something that was really powerful before.
Oh, yeah, and you know what, Winter? There was a change to Ricky the last patch, which I talked about a few times when I saw him, but haven't seen him much since then. You can now get backstab damage on denies, so it makes him a lot better mid.
You can get, also when you're denying your own creeps, you get the bonus damage.
Yeah, that's what the backstab damage works on denies, yeah.
Huh.
So
I like the other change, the one where you use spells and you're still in this.
Okay, so this is like a reverse of how the draft actually went. Like, almost, well, for Vici. For Lie Gaming, that's slightly different order.
I'm actually thinking, did they actually pick the Ricky after the Death Prophet? Maybe they wanted to do
Yes, they picked the Ricky last. That was their fifth pick.
Oh, it was the fifth pick.
They picked maybe Centaur, Scarath Mage, then they went Lich, then Lie Gaming immediately took Morphling, then Vici Gaming took Elder Titan, and then as the last pick, Vici Gaming went Ricky.
Ricky is very strong with Lich dual lane. So that lane could actually destroy the Death Prophet very hard. Death Prophet has very low armor at the start and backstab. Physical damage. The other lanes will probably be just like safe lane, Centaur, off lane, Elder Titan, nothing much. Yeah, I think it's just the dual lanes.
Yeah, I mean, that's generally what you expect with the Lich pick, so I imagine it should be the case. And with that, let's introduce our teams here. It's a best of three, guys. The winner of this match will play Newbie. I'm already assuming Vici Gaming won, aren't I? The winner of this will play Newbie in a best of three in the winner bracket finals. Winner of that goes to Kiev. Loser drops down, will face Hyper Glory Team. And loser, if that's out, the winner has one more shot to qualify for the LAN finals in Kiev. So yeah, with that being said, we've got Vici Gaming. They're on a hot tear. I think they're like 21-1 in their last 22 games. We've got Ice as the offlane Elder Titan. He'll scout out XTT, immediately retreat. Black will be going mid as a dual lane Riki with Fenrir supporting him on the Lich. Towards the top lane goes Super as the Centaur War Runner, and that leaves FY as your Scarath Mage. Meanwhile, on the side of Lie Gaming, already missing on their first D Ward attempt here, we've got 5400 playing the Rubik. Super, your Leshrac. XDD will be playing the Morphling. That puts XTT into the offlane role as the Doom, and that leaves XZ mid as Death Prophet. Team of many X's. This team's always hard for me to cast. I'll say like XDD when I mean XTT. I'll say XZ when I mean one of the others.
Difficult. Probably should just use the hero names. Then it'll be easier for you. But the lanes, both of the lanes have very high kill potential, and I'm thinking maybe the reasoning of the Elder Titan with the Ricky is to take away all the armor, so Ricky does a lot of technically does a lot of damage after that. So you can actually burst the Death Prophet down very fast.
That's true. Although Death Prophet tends to build a lot of plus armor. So
oh yeah.
I think especially against the Morphling. This Morphling's gonna have a tough time.
Oh yeah, it's better It's better against the Morphling instead of the DP. But still works very well with Ricky Maru's backstab.
Do you like the choice by Lie Gaming? So like the way the draft went was they went Lich third pick for Vici. And then Lie Gaming just immediately took Morphling. I imagine it was just a block pick. Like, they didn't want them to have Morphling.
Yeah, probably.
Plus Lich, because Vici are so good at that. But, like, do you think that's a good choice, or does Morphling not really fit into their draft that well?
I mean, he's one of those heroes that does okay when you farm a lot. Like, very, very strong later. But early game laning phase, he still gives you something compared to, like, a Spectre or, like, something like a melee, like a Spectre or a Void. But Morphling fights well early, but I still feel like looking at the lanes, Vici has much better lanes because they're going to crush two lanes with the very strong dual lanes they have. And
I do want to point out that FY has been manually body blocking this big camp. He didn't want to waste a ward on it, but he's denying the doom that creep spawns, so this forces XTT to go all the way bottom. Can't do the side pull, can't get a creep.
I think it's very important for that, for the support to actually do that. So at least you force the doom to like run really far into the jungle, like here or here. So he wastes more time. But generally, players will actually just, if you look at the lanes, like you know VG are going to do dual lanes. So if I were the doom, I would actually just run into the enemy's jungle because I'm not worried about too much because the supports are split up, one on top and one on mid.
So just go offensive jungle, you're saying?
Yeah, just go and just grab a creep, like whatever. Like they, okay. It will take them a long time to get you, like unless you're caught here and they just pincer you. But other than that, if you actually look at the map, like once the leech is missing, you just have to ditch. Other than that, I think it's fairly safe for the doom to actually jungle here. To just look and choose which creep is actually the best for him.
And just to add on to your point, if you do that at level 1, then Lich won't have a nuke, so
yeah,
they really can't kill you.
It's really safe, I feel.
Now it might be a little more dangerous.
Yeah, I don't think he had to be so like defensive with his jungling. I think he could have just like, it would have saved him a lot of time, basically.
Oh, Ice getting aggressive in this bottom lane. Two auto attacks off of 5400 and already half his health basically gone. He is bullying these supports like crazy, and with the high move speed, it's very hard for them to get their stun combo off.
And looking at like the way this is going, I think VG are getting so much better trade-off off all their lanes. They are going to have a huge lead if Lai Gaming doesn't like... They need to smoke gank, like make a smoke gank soon. Otherwise the
lanes are going to be... Where do you gank? Do you go mid?
Mid would be the best, like to kill the Lich. That would be the most ideal, so you ease off a bit pressure for the DP, but maybe they're just waiting. Like generally the best timing is like around 4 minute mark because it's night time and easier to gank, and you can actually scout the 4 minute rune and just go gank after, or gank at the 4 minute rune.
Yeah, I guess the other thing then is you'll have at least level 2 on your supports in theory, although Latrak is going to get his level 2 soon, so then you have a lot more kill potential with the Rubik Glass Shrew. Really don't have much damage at level 1, to be totally honest.
Yeah, they need to like kill the support, which is easier target, especially the Lich. If they go on the Riki, I don't think they can kill the Riki unless the Riki is low.
And that Lich is at full HP. He is playing a bit more aggressive right now, as they're getting the one other good thing for Vici is they're running this offlane Elder Titan. So if Lai Gaming do go for a smoke gank, there's a good chance the Spirit will basically give it up, even if they don't see the smoke.
Yeah,
they'll know
true.
The supports are missing.
They need to do it at a very like good time. Maybe when the creep get Sylar to push the wave. Sorry, not Sylar. I don't know why when I look at morphing, I think of Sylar. Get XDD to push the wave up and then go smoke. Maybe something along those lines. Then it's easier for the supports to actually make the rotation happen.
And on that note, XE mid lane, as expected, is struggling a lot. As mentioned, backstab does work on deny, so it's very easy for Black to keep his farm down. While getting good CS, he's already got 11 denies in this lane, and he's interrupted more last hits, not to mention the Lich denies that are coming out, so you factor those in as well, and this stat profit is just horribly poor right now.
Don't you wish there would be a stat like how many sacrifices the Lich has used in a game?
Yeah, I'm surprised that they don't show it more. Like, similar to track gold, like, things like that, it was tracked as, like, bonus gold in Dota 2 or something. Sorry, Dota 1. There was like a bonus gold category in the endgame screen, but yeah, there's still definitely room for improvement for Valve with some of those stats that they track.
I remember the thing that I missed the most is the ward spot. You can see like maybe some supports buying so many sentries and well. But at the moment, ISSS is actually still level 2, but he actually returned to the lane with extra clarity, so he just wants to make sure that he always keeps like tabs on where the supports are on the map so that the middle lane is always safe.
Oh, they're looking to go on top here. Concussive shot will come through. XTT, if they get off the stomp, will go down, but they can't quite get in range.
Yeah, he has Tranquils plus the Scorch Earth. They can't reach him.
That move speed.
Yeah, he's going to need another better creep, and this creep is... Thunderclap's not too useful for him, for the Doom at top. But he's not going to get too much farm out of the lane. His lane is... If he makes a wrong move, he's dead instantly against this duo.
The one thing I do want to say is I think Lai Gaming have made overall decent adjustments. Death Prophet's been stacking her big camp here, so just creating a comeback mechanic, and The Doom has still been getting as much as possible off that top lane. Does hit level 4.
Here comes the supports, though. They see
good timing. Good timing. Yeah. They're going to catch out the Lich. Dropping Fenrir back in. This could easily be your first blood, and it will be. Straight up and down into the split earth.
That was a really good rotation. They saw, with the safe lane ward here, they actually saw the Elder Titan went back towards, so he's not in the lane. And they immediately moved, so they knew that he couldn't scout for with the spirits. And they saw the Lich. It was just basically that gank happened because of the vision they had. It was really good. Oh, Ice, he's gonna... Oh, he actually might go down one more click. Oh, he's gonna die. Scorch Earth. Doom is gonna get the kill. Yeah. It's gonna be a regeneration rune as well spawn for the DP here.
Really nice kill on the offlane Elder Titan, and... That's exactly what Lie Gaming need. Like, they need this. Yeah, if the lanes were static, they would be losing. But with these kills, it makes it a pretty even game, actually, Winter.
Yeah, if you look at the graphs, even with two kills, VG are still, like, ahead.
Yeah, it just shows you how much farther ahead they would have been.
Yeah, now they're gonna make their own smoke with the Lich and the Skyruff. This might actually get the Rubick. Okay, the Rubick's gonna place a ward there. Oh no, he's dead.
Yeah, there's your concussive shot. The nuke's coming in from the Skywrath. One more nuke will probably do it, although 5400 does juke into the trees.
He didn't get
off his Frostblast off. Oh, there you go. But the damage was done already.
Oh dear. I think he should have used his Frostblast instead of right clicks. He was like trying to get as much right click as possible before he used his Frostblast. That actually cost them the kill.
That was super greedy.
Yeah, and you want to use your Frostblast during the seal duration as well, so you deal more damage.
Yeah, I've noticed a few teams seem to have trouble like consistently doing that. I don't know if it's just greed.
I mean, sometimes you just want like
it's like Pugna Decrepify though. It's a key part of like the hero's strength, really.
Yeah, sometimes you just want to be as efficient as with your damage as possible. You want to make sure that all your spells hit during the decrep timing. So, oh well.
And so now Fenrir will head towards the bottom rune. It's gonna spawn and at the 8 minute mark. And yeah, I'm still looking towards the mid game here for VG Gaming. Obviously, if they have really good late game still with the Elder Titan, and mainly just the Elder Titan, but you still have to feel like Lie Gaming would love to just get through this lighting stage intact, hang on to towers, and farm towards late game with a Death Prophet, Morphling, Doom, Tricore.
Yeah, Super is already online with his Blink at the moment. He just needs... Is he buying a TP scroll now? He actually is sending his Tranquils. I think he's gonna be moving soon. Maybe with a smoke, I guess, if the supports... Yeah, Skyruff has a smoke.
Oh, hasted black. Riki heading towards mid lane, and he could easily solo kill someone like the Leshrac. He's got that single point in Cloud. Hastern so powerful with the max backstab. Who needs Blink Strike at that point? But he's gonna walk right by a Radiant Observer and Sentry combo, so... Well, so much for that little jaunt. They might have even seen him going in. As Lie Gaming will now farm up that stack. It's actually the Doom who's gonna take it. He's already level 6 before clearing this out. He's gonna get a lot of golden experience. Well, maybe they give it to XE, though. He's gonna start Crypt Swarming it down, and their team juggling.
He's actually really high level. Huh. I think he got the solo... I'm not sure if he got solo XP from the kill he actually got. Oh yeah, I think he got solo kill experience when he killed Ice at bottom. Not sure. That's why he's so high level now.
Yeah, meanwhile, Riki is now prowling around, but they've dropped down sentries in all the right places, Winter. Both sentries spotting out this Riki's movement.
Except for top lane.
Yeah, well, there's no one here, I guess. Simultaneously, Vici gave me make a spoke of their own. FY and Super rotating towards the mid lane. They have Stampede and Blink on, like, oh, XE, you're probably dead. Even running, well, if he runs back right, perfect
no,
timing.
No, I think he's going to heal. At base, he's out of mana. That is just the perfect timing. Oh no, Santa actually made a mistake there. He revealed the smoke when he's too near the tower. They actually saw it.
Well, now Lie Gaming are just going to split push aggressively. Although, there's already a rotation towards bottom lane. VG Gaming, they're in kill mode now. They've got the Riki level 6, the Blink Dagger on Centaur, and they just want to keep on fighting.
I think they spotted the Rubick. Yeah, they definitely saw the Rubick. Maybe they're gonna just run straight to the Morphling.
Morphling waveforms out, dodges the stun of Super, and that'll be a missed opportunity. In fact, XDD walks in here.
He was expecting the silence to hit on the Morphling though, that's why he just blinked out.
Yeah, couldn't get it off in time. And meanwhile, they're getting some split push going here. XTT farming towards his
That was really costly though, LD, for VG. They're not farming any of the cost. Bottom lane, oh, they got a Storm and Mystic Flare on the Morphling. It's easy kill. Huh, I'm surprised he stuck for such a long time there.
Yeah, sorry for missing. I actually just got distracted because I saw this... For some reason, this Doom has a buckler and a chainmail. Like, I'm not sure what is he building? Is he just bought an extra chainmail by mistake?
I think he bought a chainmail by mistake.
I got really distracted when I saw that and lost my concentration, so I completely missed the kill bottom lane.
Maybe he just wants to stack armor.
Yeah.
I don't know, man.
I think it's the other Titan.
It has to be a mistake.
Yeah, that's a pretty costly mistake, though. That delays your mech quite a bit. And XC's gonna get caught out now. There's your Blink. Stop double-edge combination. FY and Super are starting to be all over the place. Well, meanwhile, in the mid lane, there will go into Black, who's really gotten nothing done so far as this Riki, and may actually pay with his life. The slow coming out from Lightning Storm. Is there a deny? No deny. Just a Chain Frost thrown the other way by Fenrir, but unable to really do much to follow this up. He'll make it out. Back to the bottom lane. Wave in from XDD. Chasing out Ice, chunking down his HP. Replicating. He's gonna... Nah, he can't dive that far. Won't have enough time for a secondary wave form. Good news for the Lich, that Rubick was one wave from level 6, I think. Which means he could have stolen Chain Frost otherwise, but was just a little bit short on the levels.
That's you. He actually... Oh my god. Did you see what he just bought?
Another Please. Buckler? What?
No,
is he trolling?
What is going on?
XTT?
What is going on?
Hello?
I'm sending him a private message now.
Are you really? Oh my god. Winter, don't cheat. You're undermining the integrity of Star Ladder. How is this happening?
I have no clue, man.
Like, I'm guessing he like somehow put it on his quick buy again. And he's just mindlessly using his quick buy.
Man,
but
he has to know now, right?
Dude, look at your inventory. Like, oh my god.
Oh, he sold it.
But he sold it to... Oh, no. Oh, no.
He could have had his mech now.
Oh, my God. The fails.
Oh, okay. It's like minus 300. It's fine. It's actually more than 300. 400. Minus 400.
Yeah, it's just like the psychological effect as well. You know, like, you're just like, God, I'm such an idiot when that happens. Super looks to jump in mid. Stampede. Double edge. Gets it off on two. The stop to start. Didn't get off the double edge just yet, but they bring down the Death Prophet quickly. Doom. Looking for a way in here, but doesn't have a great Doom target. Centaur's already stampeded. He's just going to throw out a stop. Now he'll do my Ice. That's a much better target as Super gets run down. Ally Gaming actually having an okay return to this fight. Super blinks it again, and well, Fenrir actually wants to go back in here. Black, though, is spot out by a Sentry Ward, but there's no real follow-up. They end up getting four.
If he had the mech there...
They would have won that fight. They would have won that fight.
Oh my god, they would have. I think his captain is so mad now. Oh dear.
Yeah, that's... Now he's got the mech recipe too. Item purchase can come back to haunt you.
Oh my god, they would have won that team fight if you had mech.
They almost won it. They almost at least broke even. Got like a 3-for-3, but...
Yeah, but they were supposed to win the fight, because if you look at VG, who's getting the mech for them? And this is a time where you have to...
Not Lich, even. He's going for a medallion, so... No mech in sight.
Ice.
Yeah. Just a rain of regen towards his mech right now. Well, and good news, they still sacrifice, so Rubick can catch up in levels. That's kind of cute. Oh, he should be using it. And meanwhile, Vici Gaming are making incursion.
He should be using it as much as possible.
Yeah, dude, that's he max sacrificed. He didn't even level up his Frost Armor yet. That's actually fairly unusual. We normally see, like, the 2 points in the ice, in the sacrifice, or maybe
three. You don't max your Frost Blast.
Yeah.
And then you take a few points in the armor already.
Yeah, the Frostbash just gives you more damage, which is still decent, but you get that slow, and Riki can do most of the work. Bottom lane, they are prepping for a potential go here on XDD, but at the same time, Light Gaming are on the smoke, and they might get a good jump here. Super would be a nice one to catch out. Doom, drop back down. That's an easy kill. They'll chase for more as XTT hunts FY, but yeah, they just get that Centaur kill. Can't follow up on FY.
They're going to try and push the tower here. Looking at... What do they have? They don't have Earth Splitter. They still have Stampede.
And they'll push in the bottom lane now. And Centaur's not up for 20 seconds is the problem. He does a buyback ready if they want to use it. Do they want to blow a buyback to try and contest this?
I think they'll be contented pushing the other two lanes, I guess.
I also want to point out, Black has done a good job of keeping his farm up. Something that Riki players can fall behind on. I mean, the hero doesn't really flash farm. But, yeah, he's got his Diffusal Blade, and this is a nice little pickup. Could be very potent against the Morphling in this game with the Mono Bird. Oh, and these supports. It's just so good to keep heroes trapped in your cloud longer. Although, it is only a level 1 smokescreen for now.
Yeah, Diffusal gives Riki so much more damage with the agility and the feedback. It's so powerful on him. And like you mentioned, some players just like, you keep trying to gank and you don't farm along the way and you fall behind. It's very important to keep the balance between farming and hunting so you don't fall behind.
Meanwhile, FY and Fenrir make an aggressive move again. They've got the concussive shot ready to go. Level 4 silence now.
Oh, the smoke broke.
Smoke broke, but... did they get vision of him? I guess they just did. Yeah, he was not up the cliff yet. And even though there's no radiant wards in this jungle, they saw him running up the hill. And they will end up backing off quite a bit. It's a concussive shot to fly, but Super just retreats back to his tower. Still, though, you see Lie Gaming are kind of almost falling behind by default, Winter, because no one feels confident to go farm the lanes with the Riki missing off the map half the time and the threat of these Centaur Blink Dagger ganks. Like, they're just not CSing aside from Morphling.
They need to, like you mentioned, they need to group up and just push a tower. This point is too dangerous for them to try and farm other lanes. The Morphling is under a lot of pressure because of this as well.
They gotta get them to jump on XE. That's the only way Lie Gaming are gonna win this fight, because they don't have a blink on their dude yet.
Die,
and they'll try to bait him out. Great reactions here with the stomp, double edge, not being possible. A super gets doomed and turned on. They'll end up getting the kill. Really nice bait by Lie Gaming. They'll chase out FY now through the river. Crypt Swarm just barely missing. Drum charges popped just to give a little bit of mobility from the high ground, but they can't go in that far. And now Black will, after dropping a cloud, retreat away from this Radiant Sentry Ward. That was really well executed, though. Instant
yeah,
lift.
The Rubick even stole the Stampede just to make sure they win that team fight, and they're gonna be able to get this tower.
Yeah, it's a very good play.
It's a very good play from Lie Gaming.
I feel Rubick is really underrated against Centaur in general.
FY, he's dead. That's rush.
Now Crypt Swarm will secure the kill. Not gonna happen. Tried for the rush deny, but nowhere for FY to go. And Winter, they're now winning in terms of gold, even in terms of experience. But you just have to imagine how easy would this game have looked for them if they had that damn mech earlier.
Yeah.
Mid lane. I mean, Black goes in on XE here, and he's chewing through his HP pool. If they get off one Frostblast, he's toast, but can't get in range for it.
If the Elder Titan was there near earlier, they probably would have got that kill with the Aura plus the Diffuser. I think they would have gotten that kill.
Meanwhile, Vici Gaming, like, I'm still a little worried for them, even with the mistakes from Lie Gaming, because I just look at this draft, like, you're farming a Riki, and eventually Death Prophet's going to get a Yule Scepter. In fact, working towards it now. Doom and Morphling will probably get BKBs. Smoke Cloud does nothing at that point to those heroes. Yule's is still not entirely a solution, but yeah, BKB is the perfect answer for Cloud, and there's still other Titan damage late game, but I feel like Vici Gaming want to be trying to get a big advantage now, not just farming for late game.
They need to get a big advantage at this point. Otherwise, their heroes are not very powerful later on. Like, Riki doesn't farm as quick as a Morphling later, or even a Death Prophet. Lie Gaming just has much better late game with the triple call they have. They're going to get the Roshan, but it's going to be quite... I don't know if they can do it fast enough before they know something is wrong, though.
Yeah.
It's pretty slow.
It's pretty slow. Backstab definitely helps here, but Lie Gaming are making their move towards the pit. They're bringing in a hasted Morphling as well. Roshan dropping pretty low. The medallion speeding things up, but they're going to have to run. It's too late. The Stolen Stampede comes in. XE charges through. He runs onto 3, doing a lot of damage, but hasn't gotten off his Doom yet. He'll end up going down to the Silence of the Skywrath Mage, the Great Mystic Flare follow, and now Super leaps in. But the Earth Splitter, it's simply not enough to cover the retreat. Waving forward is XD. Vici Gaming are getting wrecked right now. They'll end up losing 4 if XDD gets this last kill, and Black reveals himself. Do they have detection? Crypt Swarm? Almost enough. He's down to 20 HP. The last ghost will get the kill. It's a team wipe. An absolute beatdown in the pit from Lie Gaming. The team that built 2 bucklers is coming back, baby.
You make it sound like the strat was to do 2 buckers and win the game.
Dude, it's a handicap. That's how confident Lie Gaming are. Like, Vici Gaming ain't got nothing on us. We're gonna buy a buckler, extra buckler, delay our mech, and then we'll still win the team fights against you. They're looking good now. And a lot of it really has to go on this Rubick. 5,400 stealing Stampede, and then stealing Earth Splitter and throwing it against them in that fight. He won them two fights, I would say.
Yeah, he played well in the fights, but I think more importantly, the understanding of what they had to do. Like the timing, especially when they moved to get the first two kills, that was really crucial since the lanings were going really bad for them. It was more of, I think, the decision making of when and where to move was,
as a team, you're saying.
Yeah, it was much more crucial than the plays that the Rubick made in the team fights.
Okay, I can back that. XDD does have a shotgun now as well. We're only 21 minutes in, and he's opted to skip the Leaked Sphere, which we don't see often, but there's a lot of single target spells to remove it, so I kind of like
think
this choice.
It's a good decision because of the Riki. You need the Ghost Scepter to survive from the Riki.
Yeah, he can purge it, but this game's
needs
probably
to slow
going late.
You in the first place, or that's the thing.
Yeah.
Before he goes on you.
Yeah, and even if you just
in trouble.
Oh, he actually canceled his TP with the shotgun, but thought he was going to rotate towards the top lane. Not able to do so.
No, he hasn't picked up his shotgun. Otherwise, Isis would have been dead there.
Yeah, sorry, the adaptive strike, I mean. Yeah, I was expecting Isis to TP top and have the clash, but TP gets canceled, and well, Vici Gaming. Now we'll look to defend the tier 2 tower as a nuke comes out from XE, throws up one in the air, the Skyrath Mage now popping his ultimate, but this means he has no defensive Yule Scepter. He might pay for this. Yeah, he will. Instantly brought down by the double edge. Just too easy to kill off as 5,400 will steal the cloud, throwing it back the other way. But not sure this is going to be enough follow-up. And they'll lose him as well, while Super is just like, well, I don't know what you guys want from me, so I'm just going to farm these neutrals and watch
you die. That was really, really weird for them to fight, though. The Morphling didn't have TP. Didn't have Replicate up, and
he has Aegis, so you really want him in the fight.
Yeah, the Morphling could never have gotten to that fight. They were just very confident that they could win the fight. VG have 5 heroes there.
Yeah, I like Y Gaming's late game better, but
yeah,
I don't like them that much now.
They saw the Riki walk past this ward with a Sentry. Maybe that's the reason why they knew the Riki was going towards bottom, and they decided to take the fight at top, but then Riki just teleported top.
Now Ice getting 4-step forward here. He'll go for the tower last hit, but it's denied by Super. Then he gets picked off as FY tries to run, but can't quite do it. Brought down. Looking for more kills now. Fenrir kept alive by a Stampede for now. Does XZ get in range for Yule Scepter though? Phase Boots? He doesn't want to chase it that far.
And that was the Leshrocks 4-staff.
Oh, okay. Yeah, he got 4-staffed in. That was a 430 4-staff. The offensive 4-staff.
Being very underused though, usually.
And now we're gonna see a BKB come out from XDD, and this is what I'm saying against Riki, is once you get the BKB, he really can't do anything to you in the fights. Like, it just limits his damage output against the core so much, and Morphling will still be able to get off his shotgun, can still replicate, waveform. I wouldn't say Riki's 100% hard counter by BKB, but it's pretty close.
Doom will have another BKB soon as well. He's like 700.
This is a good timing for Lai Gaming.
Yeah, as long as they get their BKBs and they take the next fight, I mean, it's gonna be really hard for VG to win. They'll be relying on other ways to deal damage. I mean, they can still deal damage with the Riki. The thing is, like, they just need to get the Doom on the Riki. They can Doom the Centaur if the Centaur hasn't popped anything, but mainly is the Riki has the most network for them now, so it just needs to focus to Doom the Riki.
And overall, Winter, the Riki as a pick has just not really done anything this game. He's 2-2-3, and it's turned into a farm war. And he's got decent CS. They might even get a kill on top lane, XTT. Caught up by this Mystic Flare, that's a pretty good combo, and they will bring him down. So right as I say that, he gets a kill. But Silence will be on black, and, well, he's going to defuse that off. You don't actually fade into invisibility when that happens, but that means no Yule Scepter for XE. Now he gets turned on. The lift up black, they drop him down. The Ghost doing the work.
God.
FY gonna melt as well, but does get the Death Prophet kill in exchange. Did you see how fast black just got shredded there?
Yeah. That's the thing with melee range, goes the exorcism of melee range. They're gonna get the Rubick in return, but.
But XDD is split pushing bottom lane. He's having an easy time right now.
Black was a really big kill there.
Might find the Leshrac as well. 4-staff forward. Super has the Blink Stomp. And he'll connect on the other Super. It's Super on Super action here in the mid lane. But Super decides to have mercy on his fellow Super. To let him live. That's like being tidy and not killing the Mud Golems. You know, it's just not very nice to do that.
Yeah, you remember those times when XTT was killing XDD? It was.
Those were the dark days of Dota 2 Winter. But since then, we've seen the light. They want to set up with this Morphling top lane, but it's really a difficult kill here. Although, actually, as I say that, he's currently completely agility morphed. 100% agility morphed. So, it's not that tricky. Although, BKB might be coming now. No, it doesn't have the whole thing yet. But yeah, overall, like, the Riki as a pick, it's just you need to be finding more kills, more fights, and shutting down their farm. And they really have not shut down the Morphling this game. He's the leader in terms of CS. He's taken multiple towers. He's up 1.5k net worth on the enemy Riki, and yeah, he's had a free time of it. And Doom is starting to get big, too. Not to mention the death
profit. They're coming to get him smoked. He's probably not
going to be able to get him. He's got a replicate. Oh, he wasn't quick enough. Had like a quarter of a second to react there.
I don't think you can react fast enough on that.
It's more like if you just have your finger holding over the R key because you expect to get jumped, but yeah. He wasn't expecting to get jumped that second.
Even though if you hold your finger up there, there's like a mini cast time on that. If you get silenced or whatever, there's still time for you to get silenced or stomped.
That's true.
It's not instant like Echo Stamp.
Well, Blink Stomp this time will miss from Super. And now the Exorcism comes out from XZ, but they immediately just stampede. And this is kind of the idea of the Vici gaming lineup, is whenever they Exorcism, you just stampede, run away, and then fight when it's down. But
yeah, it's the same with the Doom as well. You Doom someone, they stampede, they get out. But someone's going to get caught, ice, get used up.
The ghosts are slowly coming back to XZ here. He still hasn't done a lick of damage with this ultimate. It's just the Crypt Swarm hurting ice. Now he'll drop a Spirit, and that's going to end the chase. Well, meanwhile, Black will take the bottom. I think the Tier 1 just fell. Yeah, takes the Tier 1 bottom lane.
He's gonna complete it SMY. It's, he has SMY. He has a lot of damage though now. Maybe he get a level 2 diffuser soon. But the thing is, I'm not sure how much right click he can do in a team fight. They have so many stuff to kill him very quickly.
Yeah, like, and even if he gets a BKB, they still have Doom. So it's, and there's the Exorcism as well.
I don't think he'll get BKB this game.
I don't even think it's a good choice, but it's just like, but if you don't, then you can just get shotgunned as well, and then you're almost dead immediately.
Yeah. Nah, I feel he's probably gonna just go more stats or more damage. Just hope that he gets a good timing to jump in the fight after they use Doom and everything on his team. Then he just, or when the Centaur just jumps in to blow someone, he just jumps in with a lot of damage and just instantly blows someone up.
This is a good time to fight. They've got a double damage rune. They just blew a Mystic Flare on a replicate. Well, that's unfortunate. You could actually see Super realized it was fake and stop, but FY had already committed to the Mystic Flare.
Did they actually see the DP in the lane or something? Did he know?
I don't know. I think he just kind of, I'm not sure if he saw her or he just was like, yeah, that's probably fake. But either way, he did stop his stomp.
That's
he probably
good,
saw her.
You have to do damage to the, even you do damage to the thing, you won't know it's fake. And
yeah, that's true. Maybe more just thinking, like, there's no way that this hero is just wandering off into the jungle right
probably.
Now.
Yeah, probably.
Like, nobody's that stupid.
Oh, they were smoked up, I didn't actually see, and he actually didn't dispel.
Yeah. XDD will now get his BKB. So that's going to be double BKB for this team, and, well, Winter, it's still a close game, only a 3,000 gold lead, 1,000 experience lead, basically dead even in terms of that. So it is going to come down for now to these next few fights, but you could tell Vici Gaming feel like a sense of urgency. We've seen them trying to force smoke eggs a lot.
Looking at the lineup, the longer the game goes, it's much more difficult for VG. Light Gaming having the advantage now actually means, like, even though it's like you just mentioned 3k gold, but it's actually more than that because of how the lineups match up against each other. VG are going to be struggling later the longer the game goes because of the triple core they have compared to Light Gaming's triple core. They don't have a triple core that's super strong later. They need to get advantage in the mid game. Even with the Aegis, I'm not sure though, because the items at the moment, it's really big on the morphing.
Black's just at that point on Ariki where I just feel like if he dies once, he's dying twice and not doing anything the second life.
Yeah, maybe you wouldn't consider giving like someone like the Centaur the Aegis so he can actually do more. I'm not sure though.
But
probably they'll probably just give the Ariki in the end as well. But here comes the smoke. Are they going to just do the rush?
Replicate into the rush. Now, well, what timing for Lie Gaming? I think it was one of the earlier possible rush respawn times. But yeah, they'll strike gold here. Easy Aegis going the way of XDD.
Huh.
I imagine we'll be the one to take
this. This is really, really huge. Like, VG needed this to be able to fight.
And now Vici Gaming may just have to wait until the Aegis is gone, or if they go for a gank, it's just like a smoke gank to kill a hero, not to like force a high ground attempt. Yeah, this is real trouble, Winter. By the time this Aegis is down, if they don't have a good fight, Morphling will have his next item. And then you're looking at Morphling getting pretty out of control.
Yeah, I'm actually thinking maybe he just goes for AC next item for the Aura and Rikimaru. Or Manta would even be decent though. I think there's a lot of items you can go, but maybe AC or Manta.
I really like the AC against Elder Titan. The only thing I would say is, well, you know, in theory Doom can get that, but then you don't get as much of the armor as if you're the one carrying.
I think at this position you want your Doom to get the Shivers because he has mech, and yeah, generally Doom doesn't have enough mana for his spells, so it's better for the Doom to get the Shivers.
So Morphling AC, Doom, Shivers, Death Prophet just gets like a heart or something.
They can even toss it around. Maybe the Death Prophet can also get the AC, depending on what they want. But Death Prophet isn't that farm at the moment.
Yeah, I think it is important for the Morphling to get the plate mail component of the AC though. Instead of just the armor aura, then you get the additional plus 10 bonus armor, so. Yeah, I kind of like your original idea the best, just to give him... At that point, he's got 15 armor that's not removed by the Elder Titan Spirit.
Maybe just, like, even get AC on the Morphling since he's much closer.
Yeah.
He's able to farm it quicker, and then DP just still gets a Shivas. They need plate mails on all three core heroes.
Yeah, I like that idea as well. And, well, Light Gaming will have time to farm them right now, as Vici Gaming are not very confident to take fights.
Even a Vlad as well, I mean. That wouldn't be too bad.
Yeah, I guess Doom could get one. I do love that refresher though. But he needs one mana item first, so he'll like have to go Shivas before refresher.
Yeah, definitely. He needs a mana item, like intelligence item on. Maybe at the moment if he doesn't want to get the plate mail, he can also get like if he finds an ogre for the frost armor. That could be helpful.
For now he is sitting on a stomping creep. Hasn't gone for a blink dagger this game, which it's the only thing they're a bit lacking in is that instant initiation, but they have shotgun for it, they have the Rubik stealing stampede, it seems like every other fight.
They have 2-4 stuff on both of the supports as well, so mobility on the supports are there.
That's true. And the push will come top lane. They'll drop a sentry ward down just to make sure that there's no Vici Gaming vision up this cliff. And they're correct about that. Now to point an observer ward here. Interesting to see that ward placed after the laning stage, but checking the vision actually gives you decent vision.
Huh, that was actually I'm not too sure about Link popping stop. That ultimate.
On to XDD. Mystic Flare's dodge though, that great defensive four staff. They also baited out the Elder Titan Earth Splitter. That's down for 100 seconds, but there's no DP ult.
I thought the DP ult was wasted, now they wasted two of their own ults as well for VG.
Oh, jumping onto XDD, they're gonna pop this Aegis almost immediately. He'll be coming back for round two. Super, still a stampede, but he's doomed. He can't get it off. They'll chase onto him. XC just going at him with auto attacks. Super is gonna live. Maybe we'll have to be denied, but shouldn't be a kill. And Morphling will now create a replica, continuing to siege. He'll have to wait for him to the low ground. Vici Gaming getting aggressive now. With all these ults down, the BKB worn off on the Morphling. He's gonna replicate the other direction. Heads to the north, trying to retreat. Well, the chase continues for Vici. They know that this is a good time. With Doom down, well, they'll dodge the split earth in the case of Black, but he gets pulled back in by Rubik Lift into the level death. Almost goes down to the nuke damage. Not quite, though. Still sticking around as XC marches forward. XDD can't finish him off. He's too heavily strength morph. Can't get the kill. The Rubik ends up dropping to the support Skyrath Mage, and it's Vici Gaming just having more heroes clumped together. Now Super runs into four by himself, but where's the backup? Morphling's waving away. They're going to sack the Lashrak as well. They end up losing 3. Literally just felt like Vici Gaming just had more heroes actually focusing the target in that fight, and they come out on top.
I mean, more importantly, Light Gaming didn't have the DP ult. They were fighting without the DP ult. That was really huge for them. Like, if you compare to what they actually used, Vici Gaming spent Mystic Flare and Elder Titan ultimate. Those two aren't as reliable as a DP ult in a fight.
Yeah,
and they took a fight. They took a fight thinking that, oh, Vici blew 2 ultimates, but at the same time, they didn't have the DP ult as well. I'm not sure about that though. They already dealt a lot of damage to the tower. I think backing off was actually much better for them, and the morph, like you mentioned, used the BKB already.
Yeah, and the even worse part for Light Gaming is they didn't do that much damage to the tower. Like, it's 2/3 of its health down, but considering the position...
I mean, it's decent though, considering...
Well, like if you do that and you don't lose anyone, it's decent. It's not really decent when you feed your Aegis multiple kills, and including the Death Prophet, and
If they would have gotten out, that would have been a really good trade for them.
Yeah, I agree. If they got out safely, it would have been a good trade. They'll jump in mid now, next DD. He has his BKB, but he can't get it off in time. That single stomp enough to finish him off. Now FY will be the turn. So they get the support Scarath Mage, but they lose their Morphling again.
He actually committed suicide, so they didn't actually get anything for that.
Oh, he's got a Bloodstone.
Yeah, he has a Bloodstone. He didn't buy anything. He disassembled his Arcane Boots for Soul Booster.
Wow, that's a... Well, thoughts on that? Is this like FY deciding that he needs to be more of a carry if his team's gonna win this?
Yeah, because this game, like we were talking about the late game VG has, it's not as good as Lie Gaming, but their supports, you know, Skyroth as a support, you can actually get a lot of kills and you get a lot of gold to buy items and transition into sort of a damage dealer, but only for spell damage later on. But he deals a lot of damage in a fight. So getting farm on Skyroth is definitely not a bad thing.
Yeah, it's also... Maybe getting to use that silence twice in one fight can be completely game-changing. If he tanks up, he's got a better chance of doing
it. Yeah,
so.
Especially when late game everyone's BKB is 4 seconds, then that's where your Skyroth becomes, you know, king again.
For now, Death Prophet BKB at 9 seconds, Doom at 9 seconds, and Morphling at 9 seconds. So they have, at you know, three, four more good fights in them where those BKBs are healthy, but Vici Gaming are looking to catch them out again. Super, he's got Stampede ready. Does he try to jump Xe and pull a fast one on him? They have that hill ward up. Super will go for the D ward, but the other super will... does he jump in here? Does he... No, he's thinking about it. Black's also getting close. Oh, also there is a Geminx TT. Important to note. But yeah. He's gonna get Mystic Third on the high ground. Well,
oh my god, he...
9 second BKB down.
He was so worried because they didn't have vision. They have no clue what's coming. So he had the BKB to be safe.
That's one way to use your 9 second BKB. I think Vici, if they want, could consider a fight now. No Aegis and the BKB.
Look at Black's item. He went for orb. I'm not sure which one he actually got first.
He got the ultimate orb first, I think.
Then he decides that he needs a BKB now.
Yeah. So what is this? Is this just an Eye of Skadi? Is it gonna be like, do you break up your Sanji Yasha
for Manta?
Yeah.
Manta is pretty okay for the Death Prophet Silence, but that's about it.
So you think more likely just a straight Skadi after the BKB for him?
Yeah, I think he wants to keep the Sanjay and Yasha. The meme is really good.
It also gives you HP, and Lie Gaming do a lot of nuke damage.
And
so.
It doesn't make sense to get this the Heaven's Halberd, because evasion doesn't really work when you're doomed. So the best choice is to just get as much HP as possible, or stats. So Skadi would be the next best choice.
Okay, I agree with you. And the other thing is that disarm isn't really helpful this game. Death Prophet ult can't be disarmed, and Morphling Shotgun disarm won't help you against. So.
Imagine if you could do that on the Death Prophet ult.
We'll see a Hood picked up now by Fenrir. It looks like he's working his way towards a pipe. And there is a decent amount of nuke damage on Lie Gaming, though also a lot of physical from the Death Prophet.
The pipe would be helpful for the one who gets doomed, though. You can actually negate a lot of the damage from there.
Now the smoke gank about to be revealed. They'll walk into Black here. They've got a jam up on XTT. Can he get off that Doom? He will, but not before the Centaur comes in. Gets off a Stomp on 2. Super dropping low will fall to the Mystic Flare nearly immediately. Welcome to the Golden City, ladies and gentlemen. Everybody's BKB now as XTT lurches forward. With this BKB, he needs to kill off at least FY. For now, Black's at full HP. The Doom's going to wear off, and now the fight may turn against them. Silence is there, and now turns on to 5400 instead. XDD caught up by the Centaur, but still has the support of XZ as this fight rages on. But they'll lose XDD. A great stomp from Ice Ice Ice. Now purging XZ, and now Rikimaru is left to do his thing. Black will find another kill. 4 dead. It's going to be 5, and it seems like Vici Gaming are just outfighting Lai. These Dooms have been very ineffective the past few fights.
I think they had to. I'm not sure though. Maybe they decided to fight even after the stampede was. I'm not sure about that though. I felt that. So what if you actually doom the Riki there? He just goes out of distance and. I mean, you didn't actually gain any advantage from that fight. And not to mention, he didn't. I'm not sure why he actually didn't burst down the Skyroth though. Maybe Skyroth just had too much HP to. I mean, for everything. I was expecting him to actually die, but he didn't die from the burst. For some reason.
Yeah, he has the Bloodstone, I guess, is the main thing. So he's able to live through a lot of punishment.
Maybe he was strength morphing. I'm not sure. His combo actually didn't do too much, though.
Oh, you're saying the Morphling. I thought you said the Skyrim.
Yeah, the Morphling. The Morphling dropped his spells on him. He didn't really do too much damage. I was watching. I was like, what? Is the Skyrim actually that tanky?
Yeah, I don't think FY's that tanky. I think he was starting to strength morph. And he just doesn't do enough damage, honestly. Like, at this stage of the game, you'd like your Morphling to be able to one-shot supports, but Lich has 1100 HP with the Hood, and the Skyrath Mage is 1700 health. So he it is undermining the Morphlings. Like, the whole idea of the hero with the shotgun is it's like kind of like having Doom, except instead of just make a hero unable to fight, you just kill a hero instantly, but it's not happening.
Yeah, now it's gonna get really difficult, because the Roshan will just respawn, and VG Gaming, having won the fights recently, are gonna be much stronger right now and much more confident to get the rush. If they get the Aegis, Light Gaming will be forced to, like, play a split push game with the DP and the Morphling, and the Leshrac and Rubick will be excellent supports to actually hold off pushes on the high ground with their spells.
Yeah, it also just feels like VG have momentum on their side, and it's something that can never be overstated in a competitive match. Just that confidence to take fights you otherwise wouldn't, and sometimes it makes the difference between a win and a loss.
Sometimes you actually, because of the confidence, you make bad decisions as well.
That's true. It can be overconfidence. Case in point, every game of Russian Dota ever. I've been casting a decent amount of Europe the past week. It's a really nice change of pace. That's the one thing I love about Starladders. You get to see all these different regions, and like, you get sick of the hero picks in one, and yeah, there's some overlap with like the Death Prophet, Skyrath Mage, blah blah blah, but there's also some fresh picks like this Riki that keep things exciting.
Yeah, for sure. New stuff is always nice. You get to explore new possibilities, and someone might actually steal the strat next time and make it better. That's how stuff works. Someone sees something and then they get another. It's a chain reaction, then they get another idea from your idea. And it keeps evolving.
It's very true. I'm a little worried for Lie Gaming at this point, just because Black is getting tanky as well.
They should be very...
Oh, mid lane. They have found out FY though. This is a big kill if they can bring him down. And well, he committed suicide again.
Just suicide again.
Oh, man. And he's going to respawn quickly with the Bloodstone. So FY deprives his opposition of yet another opportunity, and also forced out a Doom BKB. Held down to 6 seconds only.
Yeah. At this point, it's difficult for them to fight without the BKB
and
from Doom.
XC just runs right into Black.
When FY respawns, VG is at a very good position to take a fight.
Stomp from Ice, only hitting the Replicate, which XDD will now replicate into, but VG Gaming still hold the line near the Roach Pit, and they're not going to give this one up without a fight.
They have to be really careful. If one of them gets scythed by Elder Titan by Ice, immediately they'll just die from the burst. They need to be really careful with this. The four stuff has to be on point.
Especially your Morphling, who did not go for the Manta style we talked about. The Assault Curse we're talking about. He is going Yasha, probably
He's
Manta.
He's very, very squishy with the aura on him. Yeah. The Elder Titan.
At that point, he'll have 3 armor and 1300 health. Like, that's like 5 right clicks from Riki. Maybe.
I'll try to count.
Maybe even less than that. Actually, probably less than that.
I'll try to count if that ever happens.
Okay. He'll get chunked down, that's for damn sure. Black is like almost in jump range. He's just sitting a few inches too far back, but they were thinking about going on him.
Yeah, and now VG gonna be speed pushing with Skyrath Mesh, with a Boots of Travel.
It does seem like the biggest issue. Yeah, that's very cute. It's getting to that point where something you bring up a lot when we cast is really starting to weigh on Lie Gaming, and it's the fact that Centaur just completely counters this Doom pick. Like, if you don't Doom the Centaur, then you just wasted your Doom, because they'll just stampede and they just run away. And the thing is, I think that's okay if you have like a Void or something, then you can just chrono them and kill them anyway, but they don't have that reliable AoE stun.
Yeah, unless they start the fight, for example with the Doom, and the Rubick immediately lifts the guy up after the stampede, then probably they get the kill. Otherwise, whoever he dooms will probably just, get away. They need to cast their spells.
They're pushing up on mid, and they're gonna lift FY. This time, no deny, sir. FY does not have it on cooldown, but the stampede? Almost enough to keep him alive. Now they're gonna backstep, and they'll come in looking for the engagement. Ice dropping pretty low. He hasn't thrown out his Hex, so go down without using it. He'll buy back immediately, and this will cue the retreat for Lie Gaming.
They need to ditch now.
They do have Doom, but that's really about it. They'll leave a replicate here. Ultimate ending suit for the Death Prophet.
I think they just need to ditch even if they have Doom. They don't have BKBs up on all their cores. Everyone already popped their BKB. They can't fight with this.
And Vichy are just gonna go rush now. Yeah. They say, you used your BKBs, you used your exorcism, you can't fight us now. So into the pit we go.
That buyback was actually really good for my Sasas, regardless of the situation. If they can't fight, they can just go for rush. So it's a very good buyback.
This Roche is going to start dropping quickly, as Black really is getting annoyed by the Roche continuing to auto-attack and wants to get those backstab procs in. And now he will. He's taking huge chunks of HP out of the Roche and will secure himself the Aegis. This is pretty much his completed Eye of Skadi. If he wants to buy it, he needs like maybe 600 more gold.
He can just buy it with the with the Aegis on him. Doesn't have to worry. He's very powerful at this point. The burst from Light Gaming can't really... It's not that huge, so he can't really die that quickly. And just having the Skadi means if they want to kill him once, it's gonna take a very long time, and his teammates will probably just kill off someone along the way.
They'll push up the mid lane. Vichy Gaming, the one thing they do lack is a strong pushing lineup. I guess they have Centaur for the return damage, but yeah, outside of that, they don't push that hard.
The Centaur to push tower.
Yeah. Hey man, he's got a heart now. His return is...
Yeah, it's not the worst thing.
Nothing to sneeze at. But they'll push him with the Riki instead, and meanwhile they can't do it! They lose Super off the bat, he didn't get off his... Oh, actually, did he get off? No, didn't get off his Stampede. Still, they turn anyway, and Super's got a heart, so he may not have Stampede, but he also may not care either at the same time.
Oh my god!
They'll get two kills, the Morphin got chunked down, and now Black's gonna fight a third. He just one-shotted the Rubick. It's three or four shots to kill off the next, and it's a team wipe in the Radiant base. Black never lost his Aegis. Super stampeded only when the fight was over, and they can cheese Black if they just want to keep this push going. Centaur can heal up from his Heart of Taras regen, and they'll just earn him instead. FY's now got 9 charges to go.
Oh my god.
This might be Rax.
They actually took a fight when they doomed the Centaur, but they didn't drop the combo from the Morphing on the Centaur, so he didn't die. The Morphing basically just ignored him, and no one actually had enough damage to kill the Centaur.
And he just started turning and right-clicking, like...
He actually died in like 2 or 3 right-clicks.
Look at that shotgun, it only does half of FY's HP, whereas XTD is not so lucky. He's forced to Manta-style run all the way out of here, but they'll lose the Leshrac for this, and with those additional deaths coming out, that was a dieback from the Leshrac. Doom, the only hero with a buyback at this point, although now he just bought something and won't have it. And they're gonna lose their first lane of Rex, probably the game. I think this is over.
Yeah, I think this is more or less over already. DP can't... None of them can buy back. And they can't defend this Rex.
Felt like an incredibly strong timing from Light Gaming right when they got the 3 BKBs, but they really overextended in that one push, man.
Yeah, that fight, which they overextended, that was really bad at top. That actually cost them a lot of... And not to mention, they lost the Aegis as well to EG. They were in a better position at that point of the game.
I'm also not a huge fan of the items on XDD, especially going for Manta after these, but, you know, I don't know if it would have mattered anyway.
I don't think it would have mattered though, because they lost basically on decision making, and the way they took the fights, it wasn't even to the point where his items would have actually made a difference.
Now Vichy Gaming will retreat out, so they have the complete Eye of Skadi on Black. Now he's got another 3,500 gold, so he can buy his BOTs, still have buyback gold pretty much ready, and an Aegis to boot.
Sell his power chest, get butterfly. Screw boots, man. Yeah,
bootsless Riki. Hey, your team has good slows, why not?
You have Aegis, screw it.
Yeah, butterfly is such an amazing item on Riki though.
But he doesn't actually need that much damage anymore. He blew the Rubick like you mentioned in 1 or 2 clicks. Even the Morphing died like 2 clicks or 3 clicks because he was beside the other Titan.
Yeah, and it's honestly like they picked the Morphling to block Vichy Gaming from the Lich Morphling pick, but they had left Elder Titan in the pool to do it, and I still think it could have worked out for them, even so.
Yeah, but I don't think that was the main reason they lost. It was just they took a bad fight.
It happens. Unfortunately, it happens to Light Gaming against a very good team.
Like you mentioned, they were confident. They just won a team fight. They were confident of going up the push, and they just died.
If Vichy Gaming win this, they'll keep their, not their undefeated streak alive, but a big clump of wins over the past month or so. I'm still not sure it's anything more than a honeymoon phase for them, but they do look very strong right now.
Yeah, I think they're...
Blink in. Doom on Super. He didn't get off his ultimate. This time they'll focus the Centaur, but he's just too damn tanky. He's only down... Well, now he's almost dead. but it's just too much invested to kill him off. They lose the Doom, the Rubick, now they'll lose their Morphling as well. And Black's Divey Nexi, it's going to take them only a few auto attacks to kill off this Death Prophet. GG. We're going to game two, Vici Gaming. One win away from a match with an Ubi. And the winner of that would, of course, go to the LAN Finals in Kiev.
This game actually started so well for them, and then actually because of one bad fight that with the Aegis, they were pushing high ground with Aegis, and they just overextended after the Aegis went out, the BKB went out, and they turn and fight, and they just lost control of the whole game, and VG got Aegis later, the next Rosh, because of that last fight. Oh my god. They will probably be very upset about themselves.
Yeah, and I have to go back to the Doom and the double buckler, man.
They would have had mech in that first fight and actually controlled again with that mech, with that early mech.
Missed opportunities for Lie Gaming. That's what they're going to look back on this game and see. And with that, VG Gaming, take game one. Guys, it's a best of three. I'm LD, he's Winter. You're watching Star Ladder Season 10, all coverage brought to you by Beyond the Summit. We'll take a quick break, then we'll come back for game number two. Stay with us.